material inequality, I think, captures only part of the picture, that there are other factors, other senses of exclusion, which have driven societies apart. One way of capturing that is by looking at a sense of social belonging, a sense of social status, particularly of non-college educated males. This is the picture for Europe. It is actually sort of a response to survey questions over time in Europe about where non-college educated males feel they fit in society and whether what they think has happened to their social status. In most European countries, in fact, there has been a significant decline in perceived social status of this group, college-educated males. And that's I think, is another, and I think, equally important part of the underlying divisions in society that I think we will need to heal. And I will get back to when I turn to the future and what is it that we can do. But let me take a big step backwards in history to talk about a little bit about the sort of the long history of populism, in particular going back to what is really the origins of American populism. And I think we often forget that populism has a rich history. We also forget that the original and self-consciously, the first self-conscious populist movement in history really goes back to the late 19th century in the United States. And these are the original populists. And William Jennings Bryan, who twice ran for presidency of the United States, was one of the spokesmen of the populist movement. And he's remembered for what is probably the most famous piece of political oration in U.S. History, which is the statement about the cross of gold, the gold standard. And he famously said, we shall answer their demands for a gold standard by saying to them, you shall not press down upon the brow of labor this crown of thorns. You shall not crucify mankind upon a cross of gold. So what was this about? This was really about opposition to the gold standard, the symbol of in earlier eras of globalization. So we go back in history and we find that this earliest movement of populism was also linked to a backlash against the hyper-globalization of the time, that there seems to be something about advanced stages of globalization that call forth this populist reaction to it.